Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's been a while since I've filmed on this channel. I was actually trying to film on my other channel that's mostly about bags and fashion and whatever. But I thought I'd bring it up here. And I think the last time that I filmed for this channel, I was more focused on talking about conscious consumerism and being more mindful and thoughtful of my purchases. And I wanted to get on here because I wanted to show you, right? Now, I do have a few other bags in my collection outside of what you're seeing here, but I am in the process of selling those off. So the bags that you see here are the only ones that I intend to keep in my collection. Now, you're probably asking, Meg, why is it on display now? It never used to be. And that's true. I've never displayed my bags before, and I regret not doing that for a long time. But my reason is actually very basic. I have accumulated a lot of bags in the last 2 years, ever since, you know, learning about the secondhand luxury market. I've accumulated quite a number of bags, and mainly because I forget what I already have. And I forget because I don't see them. I used to store them at the top of my closet in their dust bags. So if I don't see them, I don't tend to gravitate towards them. I don't tend to reach for them. I don't tend to use them. So what I've done is this one is a Calox 4 cube shelf from, this is obviously originally from IKEA, but I got this from Hard Rubbish. Somebody probably moved out of the building and left this on the curb to be picked up by the council, right? But it's in perfect condition. It only needed a little bit of wiping. So I took it home and I wiped it down with a Dettol wipe. And I thought to myself, you know what? I'm going to display my bags. And I initially thought that I'm going to just do that because, you know, I would like it to be a background of my videos like all the other YouTubers do. But one thing that I realized as soon as I've done it is that I've only placed here, and there's like 12 bags in total, okay? I've chosen very carefully which bags I wanted to put on display. And after I did that, I realized that all the other bags that I had in my collection didn't have a place here. And the fact that I didn't include them in the 12 that I wanted to display meant that I didn't love them that much. So I decided that whatever is not going to be on display, it's gonna go on sale, right? So that's what I did. Now I'm going to then cut into a video clip of me showing you exactly which bags are on display. And if you've ever seen a bag on me that is not on here, it means that it has either already been sold or I am in the process of selling them. Okay, if you are in Australia, they probably will be on eBay or Facebook marketplace. That's where I post, really. Okay, so let's get into the curated collection. Okay, so here we go. At the top is my Chanel Surf tote. I think this is a version that, I'm not sure if it's called Surf or Executive Tote, but I got it secondhand from eBay. I won a bidding. Right in front of it is my only belt bag, and this is by Coach. This is from the men's collection. I've got here my horse and carriage print Field Tote 30, also from Coach. Really love the look of that bag. Probably one of my most favorite bags ever. This is the lunchbox bag from, this is also from Coach, as you can probably see the horse and carriage emblem on there, right? It's gotten a little bit of scuffing because it's been used, but this box leather is really very prone to scuffing. There at the back, I'll lift this out. This is my, and I'll bring the light over so you can see better. Okay, so that is my YSL Rider bucket bag. This is the large one. I actually thought that I would let this go, but after adjusting the straps and using it more of as a tote than a shoulder or crossbody, I actually enjoy carrying it now. And the bag that I took out from that is my what is this? The Chanel 19, and this is in dark beige. I don't know if it's coming across on camera as the real color, but it's called dark beige, and I think this is from the 2019-2020 autumn winter collection. I'm not sure. I got it secondhand from Vessiaire.com, and I got it just in time for my 40th birthday. Here at the back, let's take this out again, is my Coach Emery bag. Now this comes with a very long strap that's right now tucked inside the bag, but does this not remind you of the Hermes Evelyn? Just doesn't have that big age. This has got pebbled leather. Is it called pebbled or cross grain leather? I'm not 100% sure. Okay, but I love the color blocking of this, and it's really great for autumn and even spring. Well, actually, I don't really season my, I don't categorize them in seasons. I use them whenever I want to. Well, this is my card holder from, this is from Coach, and I got it for like $30 at the outlet, so I was very happy with that. I was looking at buying the, what was it called? Why aren't you focusing? Focus. There we go. Again, scuffy because of that leather material. I was looking at buying a version of YSL, that one that has got the like the chevron print with the YSL emblem on the front, but I couldn't bear to spend that much money. Like, I think it was $560 here in Australia, and I got this for like $30. So Coach it is, and it's got really, it's really good leather. So yeah, the bag that I took off of there is my Chanel lambskin. I think it's called Classic Flap, and this is the medium size. Medium is the 26 cm. Okay, it's a little bit front heavy at the moment, that's why it's doing that, but normally it will sit on its own. Secondhand as well, I bought this from a friend of mine who wanted to keep her caviar with silver hardware, that's a jumbo, and I was like, are you crazy? Yeah, I guess she was. Anyway, I bought it from her. There you go. And I remember we bought this at the Chanel store. Was it the one in Westfield? I think it was the one in Westfield here in Sydney, December 2018, because it was her Christmas gift to herself. Anyway, here we go. Right in front is a Balenciaga hip bag. This is a shoulder bag. It's a very small one. As you can probably see, if I put it against my Chanel 19, it's about that high. I got this from Vessiaire. Vessiaire has actually been really good place to buy secondhand. It comes with a very thin leather strap, but I don't normally wear it with this. I would use the strap that came with my Coach Field Tote 30, the thick woven one. And if I have a picture of me wearing it, I'll show it to you guys. But yeah, that leather strap was too long on me. But also, I just prefer the look of the wide guitar strap. There at the back is my Loewe puzzle bag in the size small. And I think this color combination is called midnight and black. So if I bring it closer to you guys, the zipper pull and the handles are black with white contrast stitching. I first saw this with the Anna Edit, this color combination, and I went hunting for it. There you go, black with white stitching. Cross grain or pebble leather. Is it cross grain or gross grain? I think I've seen it listed as gross grain as well. Small, which is 24 cm if I'm not mistaken, with gold hardware. So far the gold hardware hasn't seen any tarnishing. It still has, it hasn't gotten slouchy yet, but I can see it from this side as well. It does have the tendency, but whenever I'm not using it, I have some air paper in there to keep the shape. That's why it still looks kind of new. If I remember correctly, I think I paid like $1,700 for this. I got it off of eBay. When I asked the seller why she was selling such a perfectly good bag, she said that she wanted the, was it caramel or tan version of this that had the smooth leather that everybody on YouTube and Instagram carries. But I was like, nah, I think I like this better. It's much more understated and not everybody has this colorway. Plus, yeah, when I saw it on the Anna Edit, I was like, yeah, that's me. Right, so, and this is, I think this is my, well, no, I lie. I was gonna say this was my only navy bag, but actually my Coach one is also navy. So let's bring that back in there. Okay, and these two look like they are luxury bags, but they're not. So this clutch here, which probably makes you think, especially with this knuckles, probably makes you think Alexander McQueen, right? Yeah, it's not. It's a random bag that I got at Salvo's for $20. And so it opens up, if I can open it with one hand, it opens up like so. It comes with a chain, so you can wear it on your shoulders or even crossbody. But I often would just, especially in, I would just put my fingers in there and carry it like that. And that's my only evening clutch. And it's large enough to fit my iPhone mini. No, I don't think any other iPhone sizes would fit in here. But look at how it's almost in perfect condition. Like, I don't know. I remember when I first got this, there was like one part that had, I think it's this part here. Don't know if it's, I think it's this part here where a little bit of the leather has come undone. So I just put a little bit of super glue and tucked it back underneath the hardware and it's good as new. There we go. So that's a $20 bag. And this one here probably looks to you like an Hermes. This is actually the Handbag Craves Ava 25. So the size is 25. I believe that's measured from the bottom there. Okay. Really beautiful, rich tan shade. It's coming. Yeah, the color that you're seeing on screen is exactly what it looks like in real life. And I think this is supposed to be like a dupe for the Kelly, I think, the Kelly by Hermes. But this was like 200 something Australian dollars. It comes with a lock and key. It also came with this twilly. And it comes with a little pony, which I don't really use because I'm not a fan of bag charms. But the leather, The stitching is just so beautiful. I've carried it out maybe once or twice, but that's only because we're in lockdown here in Sydney, so there isn't really anywhere that I can go with her. Yeah, but it's so beautiful. It's so, the structure is so nice. My only gripe with this, and I'm glad that I bought this and didn't save up for a Kelly, even a secondhand, is because the handle is on here. I can't really carry it with the thing open, right? Because otherwise it just like flops around so much. Because this is also where you hook the long strap. There's a long strap that comes with it. So yeah, I think if I were to do it all over again, I'll get the smaller Birkin, quote-unquote, style from Handbag Crave. But this is still beautiful, and I would definitely use this. There you go. So yes, that is the collection. It's the collection that will stay with me. And any bag of mine that you've seen on me before will be on the chopping block. On the chopping block. There you go. Right. I hope you like this video. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, but really putting them on display, and I've put this up on Facebook as well. Instagram. I said that displaying my bags was probably the best thing that I've done, in best decision I've done, because it made me realize exactly which bags I love and which ones I can go without. So when I put this up, I was like, there you go. There's my curated collection. That's what's gonna stay. And if ever I do bring any other bags in my collection, I would most likely let go of one of them. I'll be practicing a one in, one out, but I don't really see myself buying one anytime soon. But I do have my eye on a few things. Let me know if you are curious. None of them, I don't think that any of them are the luxury kind, more like premium brands like Tory Burch and Coach. But I'll be happy to share them with you if you want to see a wish list on this channel for premium brand designer bags.